Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you quickly how to create a custom object in Salesforce. So first of all, let's log into our Salesforce environment. So when I log in, this takes me immediately to the setup and configuration page. If this does not happen for you, then what you can do is just click on this gear icon and then click on setup. Right, so once you're on the setup screen, you have a couple of options. What you can do is you can just click on create and custom object, or alternatively, you can create a custom object from the object manager. So just click on object manager tab, and then here, click on create and custom object. So once you do that, you're taken to the screen where you have to fill out some of the information. So first of all, you need a label for your custom object. So let's call mine purchase orders. Purchase order. And then I will put the plural here, purchase orders. There you go. Now it does not start with a vowel sound. And the object name here is a technical name. So for any reason, you might want to change that. Say, for example, if there's a standard object with the same name in Salesforce, you might want to name it something else. Or if you would like to always prefix your custom objects with your company prefix, like your naming conventions. Say, for example, here I might say just one bag. And the purchase order. This is something that you might want to do. So it's if you're truly building an application, prefix is a good idea. So all of your objects would have the same prefix. That's good. But for this example, we'll just leave it as it is. So description is not something that's visible to the end users. This is just for your convenience. All my purchase orders. So here, the record name, this is a little bit misleading. Actually, it's not necessarily a name. This is a unique identifier. So in my case, I will not call this purchase order name, but I will call this order number. Okay. And then I will change this from text to auto number. And then what you can do is, for convenience, just copy this example and paste it here. So the prefix here for my auto number will be PO for purchase order. And here, if you're a large company and you know, you're projecting a huge amount of purchase orders in the future, you might want to increase these zeros. So say for example this. And then just copy this again and paste it here. And then you want your very first purchase order to start with one and not all zeros. That's not nice. You definitely want to allow reports, activities, and track field history. And you absolutely want to allow search. If you uncheck this, it means that you cannot search within your purchase orders with any text. Say, for example, you can't just come here and put a PO number or a text that's inside one of your POs and search for that. So this is absolutely a critical setting. Allow search and then save. So this is pretty much it. You have just created your custom object. So here it is. It's called purchase order. And this is the API name. So this is a unique technical name in Salesforce. And now you can just go ahead and create fields in your purchase order and then put them on a page layout, create a Lightning record page for this, and a bunch of other stuff. I hope this video has been useful. So if you can, please give it a like and subscribe to my channel. That would be great help. Thank you very much, and see you in another video.